Currently, the U.S. has a weak health care service system, and therefore we feel that we should deny public health services to the people in the U.S. who participate in extreme sports. Well, we see there's a problem here, is that it's very unfair to all the other taxpayers in the country. And secondly, the U.S. has limited healthcare services and limited resources to provide healthcare. Okay, how we'll deal with the policy is that we have the person who joined these extreme sports such as bungee jumping, motocross or skydiving, we have them to sign an indemnity form before they participate in these sports. So the indemnity form will state that they understand the risk of participating in these sports and that they won't be able to, accept public health care service for 1 month after the sport. So it means that if they're injured during the sport, 1 month from that injury, they won't be able to receive public health care service. But if they want to seek private health care service, they will still be able to do so. No, thank you. No, thank you. So, with that, we still say that they can accept private health care from the country. Now, for me, I would justify it through why is it not fair to the other taxpayers, and secondly, I will talk about the weak healthcare system that America currently has. And my second speaker will be talking about that the government has the right to ensure the safety of the people. Okay. Now I'll be going on to why is it unfair to the taxpayers. Okay, this person who is getting injured when participating in these extreme sports, before he joins, he already understands the risk that he's taking, and that because it's a high risk sport, he understands that if he gets injured, the injury is going to be very serious, and the healthcare expenses is going to be very high. So how do you expect the government to cover this? Because what the tax he's paying, the tax he's paying may not be even adequate to cover the cost incurred when he himself is getting injured. So it's not fair that why he's paying this much, and if the cost he must pay for his injury is even larger, why is it that other he is able to get this priority of having other people's taxes also paying for his health care? So it's just not fair to everyone out there. And before I go on,
we think that this taxpayer, when he has paid taxes for over many years, I think it's more than sufficient to make many operations for him.
That is not true, because you have to understand that high-risk sport, if he takes this high-risk sport, is very high cost, and even if, how do you know that he has stayed in America for so many years? He could become a citizen not very long ago, and even so, we feel that it's more fair that he would pay for his own healthcare costs, because currently in the U.S. there's already a limited healthcare resources. Okay, now I'll go on to my next point about the weak healthcare system in America. Currently, America is doing reforms on its healthcare system, and because of that, the America finds that there are limited healthcare resources there. We have limited hospital beds. We have limited doctors there to provide healthcare. So we feel that the healthcare should be targeted at those who really need the healthcare, and not those who chose to go on this high risk sports.
Ma'am.
Yes.
You see, you are saying that we should give the attention to those who can actually who are really needing who really need the healthcare. Then we say that, you know, when a person is injured from this high-risk sport, then do you say that we leave them in the lurch just because they, the healthcare we are giving to them does not justify?
Of course not. We are seeing here that these people, since they already chose to have this high-risk sport, they should be able to go. They should be able to know that they are have this risk, and they should go and obtain private healthcare, and not let other taxpayers pay for their healthcare. They should understand that because of this risk, they need to have the responsibility to get their own healthcare after this shock factor that they get and this adrenaline rush they get from this this extreme sport. No, thank you, ma'am. So. From my point here, what I've shown you today, Mr. Speaker, is that these individuals want to go on this extreme sports, they should be the one to pay for this, for his healthcare expenses, because it's he who chose to be in this high-risk spot. It's not fair that they are when the expenses incurred are that high, why is it that the public should be the one providing his healthcare? He should take on his responsibility of covering his own healthcare costs after this activity. And besides that, it's because that the government has limited healthcare resources that we should be using these resources for those who really need them and not for those who just want to have fun and take part in these activities.